I just came to your baptism. word to the Philippians, beginning at verse 1 in chapter 2.
Amen.
Amen. We'll read several verses of it, amen, to get the, amen, a general idea. Amen. And so, something that I'm trying to get into, but I'm not really familiar with it because the quotations are different from the ones that I've studied for most of my preaching years. Amen. The Revised Standard Version of Scripture that we will be reading, which is designed to give you a better picture. Amen. Than the regular King James Version. Is that right? Amen. Sometimes in changing a word, it changed the whole content.
Yes, sir.
Is that right?
All right, brother.
Of the sentence. Now, from this version of scripture, it reads as follows, beginning at verse 1.
Yeah.
He said, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If any comfort from his love. If you're reading that, if you're looking at the King James Version, it don't sound like this.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
So he says, if any fellowship with the Spirit. That's why you need to be baptized with the Holy Ghost. Is that right? And if any tenderness and compassion. Boy, can you imagine? Then make my joy complete by being like-minded. Boy, now y'all listening? Having the same love, being one, in spirit and purpose. Doing nothing out of self-ambition.
All right.
Or vain conceit. But in humility, consider others better than yourself. Each of you should look not on your own interests,
yes, sir.
But also to the interests of others.
Amen.
Your attitude should be the same as that of Christ Jesus. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. Look at your neighbor and ask them, who are you imitating? Who are you acting like? Is that something? You ever thought about who you act like? Now the Bible tells us, just as you have bore the image of the earth, you shall also bear the image of the heaven. Boy, y'all look at me real good because I'm saying something. And what I am saying, amen, it don't take much for you to recognize if you won't recognize. When he told us, just as we have bore the image of the earthly, he was saying, just as we have bore the image of Adam. Is that right?
All right.
We shall also bear the image of the heaven.
Yeah.
So if you were born after Adam, and then if you've been born of Christ, been baptized with the Holy Spirit, then you have taken on the image of who? Of Jesus Christ. Is that right? Just as you, a man, a partaker of Adam. Now, since you have been born again, you are a partaker of the image of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now, we get to be that. Who do you imitate?
Who do you imitate?
Who do you act like?
Who do you act like?
Listen, do you act like Adam? Or do you act like Jesus? Is that right? Now, see, you don't have to look at your neighbor. You don't have to look at any man to observe me. You don't have to observe nobody, but take a good look at yourself and see who do you imitate. And well, then God goes a little bit deeper than that. Who do you say you imitate? When you tell somebody I am a Christian, do you know where you got the word from? The believer of Jesus Christ, the one that accepts Jesus Christ, in Antioch, they call them Christians.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Can you imagine? Amen. The reason they call them Christians, it started with the word Christians. And the reason they give them this name was because of who they act like. So much so to Acts tells us that they looked at Peter and his disciples and discovered that they were unlearned men. That the knowledge that they had was a fool. They had the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Is that right? Now this means what Jesus said.
Yes, sir.
Jesus made a plain statement, said, if any man come after me, let him first deny himself. In other words, God can't use you like you are. So you've got to get rid of who you were born, amen, and be born again. Is that right?
All right.
And being born, Lord have mercy, let me get up. Amen. Because, amen, coming down and taking a chair does not necessarily mean you're born. Is that right? The Bible tells us that we were saved by grace through faith, so much so, and said, until he said, amen, not of work shall any man boast. Other words, you don't have nothing to go around and tell somebody what you've done to be a Christian. So then, if you took on some nature, amen, or some idea of being a Christian without consulting, without being of Jesus Christ, amen, you missed the mark. So he tells us that we all, not some of, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Amen.
Yeah, I don't care who you are. I don't care where you come from. Amen. All of us that are Christians came from something.
Amen.
Some said drug addict, some said alcoholic, some, amen. But whatever, you born of the offspring of Adam, amen, you were born a sinner. And you were born in sin. What you call it, little or much. You're a sinner. Is that right? By birth. David said, behold, I was.
Yes, sir.
Born in sin. And from my mother, I was shaken in. So all of us are sinners because we are born after the offspring of Adam.
Amen.
So when Nicodemus, one of the rulers, came to Jesus one night and said to him, Watch me now. We know that thou art not from here. He didn't say it that way, but I'm paraphrasing. Because you couldn't do what you do if God wasn't with you. And Jesus said, don't bring me all of that stuff. Marvel not. Well, don't wonder about it. He said, amen, that you must be born again. Nicodemus had good religion. And then he looked at Jesus, amen, and said, how can these things be? Jesus looked at him and said, man, you trying to tell me you a ruler of Israel? And know not these things? And then said, there's no way I can tell you because you don't know earthly things. How's I going to fill you in on heavenly things? Is that right? So he said, that which is flesh,
yes,
is flesh.
Yeah.
And that which is spirit,
yes,
is spirit.
Yes,
is that right?
Amen.
Amen. So Paul to the Rome, he made it plain unto them that those that walk after the flesh, we're parents. So he goes on to help us to realize that we are not of the flesh. We're born of the spirit. And then he gets on so far along till he tells us that if we do not have the spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, and then we are not of Jesus. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Look at the name, man. Who are you acting like? Amen. We don't have a problem acting like that. Is that right?
Uh-huh.
Boy, that rubbed me a little bit wrong. See if I don't act like that. But he tells us here in Philippians. I read, and I took the notion to do this translation. He says, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, do y'all know what that is? How often you talk about Christ? How often do you tell folks about you being a child of God? How do we do that?
My Lord.
And the most of us, you ask if they've been saved, what do you think they did? They tell you what church they go to and who they pass off. That's not what they ask. They ask, are you saved? Amen. Paul said, I am what I am.
Yeah.
By the grace of God. I didn't get here myself, but the love of God constrained me. God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. This is not to examine somebody else. This is for self-examination. Is that right? Now watch what he said. I'm going to go on with him. He said, if not only, amen, should we talk about it. Not only should we go ahead on and tell folks, amen, that I'm a child of God. He said, if any comfort, is that right? From the love of him. Any fellowship with the Spirit. Does the Spirit have control over you? Do you have so much love in your heart that you're more concerned about somebody else than you are about yourself? Are we still with that thing that we were born after Adam, selfish? Let me get mine, and after I get mine, if anything left, I'll let you have something. But I ain't fooling with you until I get mine. You know who that is, don't you?
Yeah.
That's acting like that. Is that right? We were born selfish. But being born again, every man, we deny ourselves and not become selfish. Is that right? He said, then make my joy complete by being like-minded. Boy, I need the mind of Christ. If you, born of the Spirit of God, you have a mind of Jesus Christ. Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. But when you start to examine yourself, you're going to get to shouting on this. Do you act like Jesus? Or do you act like Adam? Is that right?
All
right. So when you start examining yourself, you're going to find that you are more like Adam than you are like Jesus. What I mean by that, we are more caught up in what the world has to offer than what heaven has to offer. If we are born from heaven, amen, we are just down here working. But our destiny is where Jesus is. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Boy, I'm going to close here. That's what he said. Having the same love, being one in the spirit and purpose. Do you know your purpose? Do you understand being born of the spirit? So he goes on to tell you what he's saying. Do nothing out of self ambition. Well, y'all know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Self ambition is one serving God, or doing what his own thing, doing things for his own interest. Are you listening? Don't you know a whole lot of preachers are not preaching the gospel because they're the love of God in their heart?
Amen.
This become a job, and this is the way folks go to school so they can learn how, and amen, to draw folks to them wherever that they can draw their sound.